Shelby County Schools wants $10 million above their budget for a number of efforts, including pre-K classrooms and boosting literacy. But last week, the school board delayed a vote on their budget as Shelby County commissioners need to weigh that request.
Tonight, the school board is expected to take up the vote once again. And joining us this morning to discuss the reasons behind the requested increases is Shelby County School Superintendent Dr. Joris Ray, along with Deputy Superintendent Lynn Johnson. Good to have you both.
Good to see you, gentlemen. How are you?
Good morning.
We actually spoke with a couple of commissioners last week about this. Both of them seemed fairly optimistic and supportive. What is going to be your pitch, Dr. Ray, to the commissioners?
Well, thank you all for having us here. Pitch is simple. We want to do what's best for children in Shelby County Schools. We know early literacy is very important. Our students reading at or above grade level by third grade is paramount. Not only that, social emotional learning needs for our students. Childhood trauma is real. Mm-hmm. Tonight at the board meeting, it's just a preview of talking about a priority group, African-American males. If you've seen what's going on in Memphis and Shelby County around African-American males, you know, how is Shelby County Schools contributing to the societal ills? So just unpacking the data and looking at what focus are we going to bring around social emotional learning to lift this priority group. Last but not least, high schools. We can't have a cookie cutter approach to high schools any longer. The governor so generously dedicated over $25 million to college career technology education. So we have to have a laser focus on high schools. 23% of our students scored a 21 or higher on the ACT. Mm. That means over 77% of our students aren't college ready.
We got you. Going back to the budget, though, the $10 million more
yes.
requested. Again, did you not see this one coming a little bit earlier? I mean, for some people, this is kind of sticker shock when you hear that request and you see it down on paper. Did we see this one coming, and should we?
Well, you know, we have so many needs. I would love to have a one-on-one devices, teacher assistant in every classroom. I could have a $150 million ask. However, you know, working with Deputy Johnson here and the team to really prioritize what's best for children, our $1.4 billion budget is directed towards our students in Shelby County. Mm-hmm. So, you know, again, I'm a new superintendent, mm-hmm. and so this is something. This is my first budget, if you will. And, you know, I wanted to do my due diligence to get it right.
So, Deputy Johnson, what about it? Will there be a lot of arm twisting you think will be needed with Shelby County commissioners to sign off on this deal? And have you also spoken with Shelby County Mayor Lee Harris? Where do you think he stands on it?
Yes. No, I don't see a lot of arm twisting. I think all parties are really supportive of supporting our kids and ensuring what's best for our kids. And this is including our mayor as well. I think everyone wants to make sure that our kids' needs are being met.
If I were a commissioner, my only question would be, how are you going to be accountable? And how are you going to show me exactly what percentage of not just that $10 million, but all the money stays in the classroom and goes to these very targeted efforts? You know, I know you're a numbers guy. So how are you going to show them that?
So I think as part of this process, for every investment that we're making, we're going to monitor throughout the year to ensure that we're have benchmarks and we're on track for that investment. So take something as easy as universal phonics. We're going to be tracking the proficiency level for the K through 2 to ensure that our kids are on track, and that investment is producing the return on investment.
And do you feel with education, and you know, you're both educators, it takes a while. So do you really think you're going to see much improvement in just a year's time? Well, and are they going to demand that?
Well, we have to set the expectations high. Yes, I do want to see some improvement in less than a year. I have great teachers and great principals, mm-hmm. and I have full confidence in their ability to move the needle academically.
We also know what's being asked of Shelby County commissioners, but what about on the state level? There's been so much emphasis, so it seems, mm-hmm. on vouchers. We hear
yes.
so much talk about mm-hmm. that. How will Shelby County Schools be impacted by that?
Well, you know, I haven't shied away from this at all. I've met with Governor Lee. We've had a phone conversation, 30, 40 minutes, about vouchers. You know, it's just not good for Shelby County. And we've made that very clear because we have choices. I think the governor wants to get at school choice and choices. We have over 100 plus choices within Shelby County for students. And we're going to exhaust all legal means and ramifications to, fight it.
What was the governor's response, though? How did he respond to all of this?
Well, you know, as I said, you know, I think the governor's heart is in the right place, and I've shared that publicly. I think he got it right as far as CCTE, College Career Technology Education, dedicating $25 million. But on this particular issue, he isn't, you know, correct. But we agree to disagree. At the end of the day, we still want to work together for the betterment of all students.
And you mentioned students being college ready. Is there going to be a focus on technical school? There are some great jobs that are not going to be able to be done by a robot or sent globally that can provide a very nice income.
Yes, and Lynn definitely can share more. But last year, we dedicated over $8 million to college career technology education. Again, the governor has poured in $25 million. Okay. Again, we cannot have a cookie-cutter approach to high school education no longer. Also, we want to prepare our students when they leave us, if they decide not to go to college, which we're going to prepare all students to go to college, sure. But if they decide not to go to college, they can walk into a high-wage job and leave us with a certification. So I want to brag here for a little bit. Last year, our students only had 300 certifications completed. Mm-hmm. Now we have over 2,000 certifications
where
in our students
where
they can step into a job.
Got to wrap you up there. Also, Shelby County Schools partnering to bring about more vocational jobs as well. So that's great.
Absolutely.
All right, gentlemen, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Stay in touch with us.
We will.
All right.